is Nastasha Romanenko. A pleasure to work with you, Solid Snake.
You're the nuclear specialist that the Colonel mentioned?
That's me. You can ask me anything about nukes that you want. I am also a military analyst, so I have an extensive knowledge of weapon systems as well. They asked me to participate in this operation as a supervisor from the Nuclear Emergency Search Team. I was happy to accept. We must not allow terrorists to get their hands on nuclear weapons of any kind. I hope I can help you to stop them.
You're a tough lady.
Those terrorists are serious about launching a nuclear weapon? The world cannot stand by idly and allow that to happen, and neither can I. Unfortunately, all I can do from here is provide you with information.
Hopefully that'll be enough. Another soldier here wouldn't make a difference anyway. It's good to work with you, Nastasha.
Same here, Snake. That is C4 explosive, a plastic explosive with a texture similar to clay. So you can shape it in almost any way you want. Although it has 1.4 times the destructive power of dynamite, it is highly stable and won't explode without a detonating device, even if it is shot, burned, or beaten. You are using a wireless detonator, yes? The detonator is equipped with a scrambler, so you don't have to worry about interference from any other radio source. Make sure you are sufficiently far enough away when it goes off. Also, as you know, the sound of the explosive will alert your enemies, so be careful. You found some grenades. Just pull the pin and it explodes after 5 seconds. You can get a lot done during those 5 seconds, Snake. How you use them is up to you.
Snake, you can't use your radar in that area. There's some kind of electronic jamming coming from there. I wonder what it is. Anyway, be careful.
Am I too late? He's alive. You're the arms tech president, Kenneth Baker, right? Don't worry. I'm here to save you.
No, no, don't touch it!
C4.
Right. Touch that wire, and the C4 will blow up along with the old man. So you're the one that the boss keeps talking about.
And you?
Special Operations Foxhound. Revolver Ocelot. I've been waiting for you, Solid Snake. Now we'll see if the man can live up to the legend. This is the greatest handgun ever made. The Colt's Single Action Army. 6 bullets, more than enough to kill anything that moves. Now I'll show you why they call me Revolver. Draw! Draw! Hiding won't help you. I understand. I love the reload. All right, alive. Let's go. Pretty good. Just what I'd expect from the man with the same code as the boss. It's been a long time since I had such a good fight, but I'm just getting warmed up.
What? My hand!
Stealth camouflage. Can't you even die right? You were lucky. We'll meet again!
Who are you?
I like you. I have no name.
That exoskeleton.
DARPA chief told me he gave them his detonation code. What about yours?
Oh, I get it. Jim sends you. You're from the Pentagon.
Answer my question. What about your code? There's no time.
I talked.
What? Now the terrorists have both codes and can launch any time.
It's not like I didn't fight. I managed to resist Psycho Mantis's mind probe.
He couldn't read you? How'd you do it?
Surgical implants in my brain.
Surgical implants?
Kind of like a psychic insulation. Everyone who knows these top secret codes has it.
Even the DARPA chief?
Of course.
But the DARPA chief said Mantis got his code by reading his mind.
Are you sure you heard him right?
Yeah, I'm sure. In that case, how did they get your code?
I never had any training on how to resist torture.
It looks like he had some fun with you, all right.
Oh, he's not human. I tell you, he loved every second of it.
What happened to your arm?
He broke it.
Looks like you're more than even now. His was sliced off.
Ha! You're a funny man. So the DARPA chief, is he okay?
Dead.
What? That can't be. No, no, that's not what you promised, Jim. Now you want to shut me up? Oh.
Calm down. What's wrong with you? I just told you I was here to save you. I didn't kill the DARPA chief. He had a heart attack or something.
A heart attack? Oh, don't be a fool.
Anyway, the terrorists have both codes now.
Those boys are totally insane. They wouldn't hesitate to launch.
I agree, but what do they really want?
Who knows? Maybe they're like us in the arms industry, always looking forward to the next good war.
Well, I'm not gonna let these maniacs start a war today. You still have the card keys?
Card keys?
To override the detonation code, I heard you had them.
No, not anymore.
What? Who does then? Not the terrorists?
No, that woman.
Woman? Who?
A soldier that was thrown in prison along with me.
A female soldier, it must be.
She said she had just joined up as a new recruit. They threw her in prison because she refused to take part in the rebellion.
A new recruit? Could that be the colonel's niece?
I gave her the key. Looks like she managed to break out of here, though. I hope she's okay.
I'm sure she is. She's green, but as tough as they come. But how did you know she escaped?
I was in contact with her by codec. Until I was tied up here, that is.
Codec?
Yes. She stole it from the guard. If she still has it, you should be able to contact her.
I'm sure she still has it. What frequency was she at?
Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, it's... Oh. Oh. Sorry. I forgot.
Damn!
Oh, that's right. It should be on the back of the CD case. Try to contact her.
I'll contact her right away. But tell me, if this doesn't work, is there some other way to prevent the missile launch?
You need to find Hal Emmerich, one of my employees.
Who's that?
The team leader of the Metal Gear Rex Project. A genius at engineering, but a little bit of an oddball. If there's anyone who can figure out how to stop Metal Gear from launching, it's him.
What if he can't come up with anything?
You'll have to destroy it. Emmerich knows how to destroy Metal Gear.
Where is this Emmerich?
Well, he's probably being held somewhere in the nuclear warhead storage building. It's north from here. That's where he worked.
I understand, but why Metal Gear? The nuclear age ended with the turn of the millennium.
Oh, you're wrong. The threat of nuclear war isn't gone. In fact, it's greater than it's ever been. The amount of spent nuclear fuel and plutonium is increasing even today. Listen, have you ever seen a warehouse full of nuclear material?
No.
Drums and drums of nuclear waste stacked this high, as far as you can see. Because there's still no real way to dispose of the stuff.
So they just close the lid and try to pretend like it'll go away?
Essentially, yes. And they're not even doing a good job of storing it. Many of the drums are corroded, with nuclear waste seeping out of them.
Unbelievable.
Not only that, but several pounds of muff are reported every year.
Muff?
It stands for material unaccounted for. It proves that there's a large and well-organized black market in nuclear materials. Furthermore, since the end of the Cold War, Russian nuclear engineers in particular are out of work with no way to turn. In other words, there's plenty of available nuclear material and scientists for making a bomb. We live in an age when any small country can have a nuclear weapons program.
What about the other superpowers?
Russia and China still maintain a significant nuclear presence. Complete nuclear disarmament is an impossibility. To maintain our own policy of deterrence, we need a weapon of overwhelming power.
You mean Metal Gear.
Yes. You know, our industry suffered quite a blow as a result of the cuts in military budgets due to this so-called peace.
I remember hearing a lot about mergers and takeovers among the big weapons makers.
Yes. And after my company lost their bid to produce the Air Force's next line of fighter jet, the Metal Gear system was our last ace in the hole. That's why we pushed to have Metal Gear developed as a black project.
Black project?
Secret projects paid for by the Pentagon's black budget. You can avoid a lot of red tape and get a great lead time on your weapons production. And no one can bother you. Not even those bleeding heart liberals on the Military Oversight Committee.
Bribes.
I prefer to think of it as good business. Anyway, Metal Gear was going to be formally adopted after the results of this exercise were analyzed.
I don't give a crap about you and your company.
Yes, that's about what I'd expect from a grunt like you. Here, this is what you came for, right?
What's that?
An optical disc. It's all here. The main hard drive was destroyed by gunfire. This is the only remaining copy of the data.
What kind of data?
All the data collected from this exercise. Don't play dumb. I know you were sent to get this. I hid it from that sadistic maniac while he was torturing me. They don't know this disc exists. Make sure you report this to Jim. To your boss. I'll give you my card, too. It'll open up all security level 2 doors.
Can you walk?
No. No, you go on without me. They got my password. They don't want anything else from me.
I have one more question. Who or what was that ninja thing? It looked like you knew something.
That ninja? That was Foxhound's dark little secret.
Dark little secret?
An experimental genome soldier.
You know him?
You should ask Dr. Naomi Hunter from Foxhound. She knows better than I.
Naomi?
You've got to stop them. If it goes public, my company and I are finished.
What? Doesn't Metal Gear use currently existing technology?
Metal Gear itself does, but... What? What did you do to me? Oh, no, it can't be. Those Pentagon bastards. So, they actually went and did it.
What are you talking about?
They are just using you for...
Are you listening? Now he's dead too.
I have no idea.
Don't lie to me.
It looked like another heart attack, but...
Some kind of poison?
Well, there are lots of drugs that can cause a heart attack in large doses. For example, potassium chloride or dioxides, but we won't be able to tell without doing an autopsy.
Damn!
Snake, I want you and Meryl to work together.
Can I trust her?
More than you can trust me. Get in contact with her.
Snake, there's a lot of electrical interference coming from there. It should be okay if you do burst transmission like us, but normal transmission is probably impossible. Try moving away from that area.
Snake, get a hold of yourself.
Naomi, what the hell was that ninja thing? A member of Foxhound?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes, we have no one like that in our unit.
Is that right?
Snake, I'm counting on you.
room is set with infrared sensors. You should be able to see them if you had some smoke, cigarette smoke or something.
Sorry, but these are smokeless cigarettes.
You mean those cigarettes that are designed to cut down on secondhand smoke? Oh, well, don't worry. If you blow the smoke in the direction of the infrared sensors, you should be able to see them. That was a good idea, bringing the cigarettes, but don't smoke too much. Cigarettes make you weak in mind and body. They are bad for you. That is a FAMAS. It is a bullpup-style assault rifle. It is durable and easy to use. Very resistant to overheating, it is a reliable weapon with smooth action. It can fire up to 1,000 rounds per minute. On full auto, you will empty a 25-round magazine in a few seconds.
Like Shakespeare said, knots had, all spent, for our desire is got without content. Basically, it means that your desire can get you into trouble if you're not careful. That goes for items, too. Don't get too greedy or you might be sorry. Be careful, Snake.
Who are you?
I was really impressed with the way you busted yourself out of there.
The one from the prison?
You're the Colonel's niece, Meryl, right?
No, it's not him. Just exactly who are you?
I'm the fool that your uncle sent all alone into the middle of this whole mess.
You came by yourself? You think you're some kind of one-man army?
I don't need lectures. You're just like your uncle, you know?
How do you know my uncle?
We go way back.
What's your name?
My name's not important.
Aha. Could you be Snake? Are you Solid Snake?
That's what some people call me.
The legendary Solid Snake? You? Sorry about before. I wasn't sure if you were one of the good guys.
But I knew you were.
How?
It's your eyes.
My eyes?
They're not soldiers' eyes.
And they're rookies' eyes, right?
No. They're beautiful, compassionate eyes.
Oh, just what I'd expect from the legendary Solid Snake. You trying to sweep me off my feet?
Don't worry. You'll land back on them once you meet me. The reality is no match for the legend, I'm afraid.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Why did you look so surprised when you saw my face?
Because you look just like him.
You mean the terrorist leader, Liquid Snake?
Yeah. You know him? You're not brothers, are you?
I have no family.
So what's the deal, then?
Who knows? Why don't you ask him? But first, I want some information. You were involved in this exercise from the beginning. What exactly happened here?
I'm sorry. I was captured along with President Baker right after the terrorist attack.
That's okay. But what is this place? I don't think it's just a nuclear weapons disposal facility.
Boy, oh boy, it's just like them. Nobody told you anything, did they? Okay. You see, this place isn't really for disposing nuclear weapons. This base is owned and operated by a dummy corporation of arms tech.
This is a civilian base?
Right, for the development of Metal Gear.
Colonel,
Foxhound and the Next Generation Special Forces were called here for the test launching of a dummy nuclear warhead.
Why Foxhound?
Because they're a special ops group used to handling top secret missions. They figured they could help keep it all hush-hush.
But we must have fired nuclear warheads before. Why just this time?
I heard it was because this was to be a final test before the formal adoption of the Metal Gear program. Well, that's what I heard, anyway.
Sounds kind of fishy. So what do you think the terrorists want?
Sorry. I'm not sure. I was captured with President Baker right after the revolt started.
Oh, yeah. That's when he gave you the detonation code override keys, right?
That's right.
Amazing you were able to keep him hidden from the guards.
Well, women have more hiding places than men. Anyway, you met Baker, huh? How's he holding up?
He's dead.
What?
Heart attack. Same as the DARPA chief.
The chief died from a heart attack, too?
Yeah. Was either of them sick or anything?
No, not that I heard of.
Well, I don't believe in coincidences. Something funny's going on.
Sounds like it, but I have no idea what.
Me neither. Yet. Do you know the person who designed Metal Gear?
You mean Dr. Emmerich?
Yes. Is he still alive?
Probably. He should be in the research lab in the second floor basement of the nuclear warhead storage building to the north.
Second floor basement?
Yeah, that's where his lab is. I think they're forcing him to work on the nuclear launching program.
So they'll need him alive until that's done anyway.
Then we better do something before he finishes.
You're right. In case we can't override the detonation code in time, I need to ask him how to destroy Metal Gear.
You plan to take that thing on by yourself, Snake?
It won't be the first time. What's the best way to get to the building where the doctor is being held?
There's a cargo door on the first floor of this building that leads to the north.
What's the security level of the door there?
5. But it's okay. I've got a level 5 card.
Well, I've got to go save the doctor. You should go.
I'm going with you.
No way. You're still too green. I want you to hide somewhere.
I'm not green.
Oh, yes, you are. You pause for just 1 second in front of your enemy and it's all over. Good luck doesn't last forever.
I don't know what happened. I just couldn't pull the trigger right away. I never had any problems in training. But when I thought about my bullets tearing through those soldiers' bodies, I hesitated.
Shooting at targets and shooting at living, breathing people are different.
Ever since I was a little girl, I always dreamed about being a soldier. Every day of my life, I've trained my mind and body for the one day when I could finally see some real action. And now...
So what now? You want to quit?
I can't quit. I can't allow myself to quit now.
Listen, Meryl, everybody feels sick the first time they kill someone. Unfortunately, killing is one of those things that gets easier the more you do it. In a war, all of mankind's worst emotions, worst traits come out. It's easy to forget what a sin is in the middle of a battlefield.
But this isn't a war. It's a terrorist action.
You're just a little jumpy from the combat high. The adrenaline in your bloodstream is starting to thin out. Just take it easy.
But I learned all about combat high at the academy.
We'll talk about it later. For now, just think about keeping yourself alive.
If I get out of here alive, I'll think about that other stuff.
Okay. Let me try to say this another way. Stay the hell out of my way.
You're a real bastard. Just like my uncle said.
Huh. I told you. The real me is no match for the legend.
It looks like you were right. Okay, Snake. I'll be a good girl.
We'll link up after I grab the doctor. Then we'll take care of the detonation code
override. Gotcha. But listen, I know this area better than you. Call me if you have any
questions. Be careful,
okay? After I open up the cargo door, I'll contact you.
Good. You found a SOCOM. That's a Special Operations Command pistol. It's a .45 caliber pistol with plenty of stopping power. It's also equipped with a LAM for nighttime combat. If you hold down the weapon button, you can train the laser sight on the enemy to help you aim. If you find a SOCOM suppressor, you can equip that too. That pistol was designed specifically for use by special forces, so I think it will be useful. Some people find it a little heavy and hard to use, but it shouldn't be a problem for you.
Snake, I unlocked the cargo door for you.
Thanks. Where are you?
Where I can see ya.
Don't move around too much.
Don't worry. I'm disguised in this enemy uniform.
You won't be for long with the way you walk.
What does that mean?
Nothing.
Listen, Snake. The cargo door is like an airlock. It's equipped with infrared sensors. Be careful. If an intruder is sensed, gas is released.
Gas?
Okay, so we'll meet at the nuclear warhead storage building.
Wait, you said you'd stay put and be a good girl.
I changed my mind.
Don't get careless. That's when things always turn sour.
Sorry, but this is the only way I can figure out whether or not I'm cut out to be a soldier. I gotta get my hands dirty.
These guys are professionals. You're gonna get yourself killed.
See you there.
Airlock is set with infrared sensors. You probably can't see them with your naked eyes, but there are infrared beams coming out of that wall. Touch any one of them, and the doors will seal off, and the place will be flooded with poison gas. Somehow, you've got to get through without setting off those sensors.
Thank you.
snake in China, they say. You must cross the river before you tell the crocodile he has bad breath. Do you know what that means? It means that the wise man avoids danger first. Use your brain to avoid traps and stay away from the enemy.
Snake, be careful. There are claymore mines around there. Use a mine detector.
Who are you?
Just call me Deep Throat.
Deep Throat? The informant from the Watergate scandal?
Never mind about that.
You're not using burst transmission. Are you nearby?
Listen, there's a tank in front of your position waiting to ambush you.
Who are you anyway?
One of your fans.
Master, does the name Deep Throat mean anything to you?
Deep Throat? What? You mean the guy from Watergate?
No, but he uses the same name. Whoever he is, he's not part of our operation, but he's been giving me advice by codec.
What?
On top of that, he wasn't using burst transmission. It seems he was transmitting from somewhere on this base.
Somewhere on the base?
Yes.
I have no idea who that could be.
I see.
Colonel, I got a codec call from someone outside this operation.
I know. We were monitoring the call. Mei-Ling knows everything about the communication system, so let me have her explain it to you.
Well, if somebody knows your frequency, they can call you. But the question is, how did he learn it? It's top secret information.
So you mean someone leaked the information?
That's the only explanation I can think of.
Mei-Ling, do you know where that transmission originated from?
I'm sorry. The radio waves were too weak to locate their source, but I'm sure he's near you, somewhere on the base.
Snake, you'll have to go through the minefield to advance.
That area is mined? After you locate the mines on your radar, crawl forward and retrieve them. Anti-personnel mines have killed over 20,000 non-combatants in the past 30 years. In countries like Cambodia and Nicaragua, the killing and maiming of innocent victims continues long after the wars have ended. It is easy to plant mines, you see, but removing them is a different matter. It requires more time and manpower than anyone is willing to invest. The superpowers need to donate more mine detectors and other equipment to remove them. It is the least we could do after laying them.
I will not let you pass. Send him a message. That's right. You belong on the ground. You should crawl on the ground like the snake you are. Let's fight!
Well, boss, I hope you are happy. He got the card.
We'll play with him a little longer.
You would be wise not to underestimate him.
What did you think of him?
He is just as you said. In battle, he is as if possessed by a demon, much like you. I would expect no less.
See? I told you so, but I will kill him.
So, General Ivan, I hear he took your hand as well as your dignity.
Watch your tongue, Shaman.
In the language of the Sioux people, Sioux means snake. It is known as an animal to be feared.
Well, snake is mine now. When I meet him next, I'll take special care of him. Not yet. Don't kill him yet.
He and I will meet again in battle.
Same prediction as always?
Yes. The raven on my head. It thirsts for his blood.
Those are claymore mines. Unlike other mines, which are planted underground, claymores are set up above ground and are designed to produce maximum damage in a wide fan-shaped area. When they go off, they spray 700 1.2-millimeter steel pellets in a 60-degree pattern, much like an oversized shotgun. Traditionally, claymores use a tripwire to set them off, but those claymores are a new type. They are camouflaged using the new stealth technology and are equipped with sophisticated motion detectors.
Snake, like Confucius said, the cautious seldom err. If you proceed cautiously, you probably won't make a big mistake. Snake, even after you get used to the mission, don't lose your concentration.